Hi everyone, Mr. H here. So good to see you again. And today we're going to talk about something pretty special. We're going to talk about the instruments of the orchestra. Now these are the instruments that you might see, well, in an orchestra. So there's a lot of them that combine all together. Now when we talk about them, instruments like these, they come in what we call families, which means they're all grouped together because they're either made the same way or they play the same way or they sound really close together. So one of the families that we have is called the woodwinds. They're called the woodwinds because either they were traditionally made out of wood or they use a piece of wood called a reed to make the sound. The instruments in the woodwind families are called the flute, the clarinet, the saxophone, the oboe, and the bassoon. And we're going to talk about most of these today. The next instrument we have are the brass instruments, which are traditionally made out of, well, brass. And brass is a metal that looks like it's gold, but it's really not. And it makes it so that the sound is a lot louder, a lot brighter, and you can hear it from far away. These instruments in the brass family are the trumpet, the cornet, the French horn, the trombone, the euphonium, the baritone, and the tuba. And we're going to talk about a few of these as well. After that, we have the percussion family. Now, these are the ones that are made by, they're used by hitting them with sticks or just hitting them themselves to make the sound. These include the snare drums, the bass drums, the xylophone, and the marimba. And finally, we have the string family, which are instruments that use strings to make their sound. These are the violin, the viola, the cello, the string bass, and the guitar. Now, we're not going to talk about every single instrument on this list, but we're going to talk about a lot of them. And we're also going to listen to them a little bit as well. So as we go, take some mental notes about what you're hearing, about which one goes where. So we're going to start with the woodwinds, and we're going to start with the flute. Now, the flute's kind of silly because it's not actually made out of wood, and it doesn't use wood to make the sound. If you look at this part up here at the top, that's actually how you make the sound. Now, what makes the flute a woodwind is, well, flutes used to be made out of wood, but more importantly, they use these keys. Those are the little buttons you see that people press down with their fingers to change the sound. These keys that they use are the same as other woodwind instruments, so they make a flute a woodwind instrument. So really quickly here, we're going to listen to a few seconds of the flute playing. This isn't the flute. This is the background. That's not the flute either, but it's close. Here's the flute. Okay, now we have to go really quickly because we have a lot of instruments to talk about today. So we won't be able to listen to every single video, but if we want to go back through the through things later, we might be able to. But anyway, that's the flute. Did you see how when she played, she didn't have it in front of her, it actually played off to the side and she was blowing over the top of this hole at the front. That's how the flute makes its sound. It's kind of like blowing over the top of a water bottle or a soda bottle to make the sound. There we go. Now, the next one we're going to talk about is called the clarinet. Now, as you can see on this picture, there's a bunch of different kinds of clarinets. Now, most people know the clarinet as that instrument that Squidward plays in SpongeBob SquarePants. When they're talking about that clarinet, they're talking about this one on the left, which is called the soprano clarinet. But then they also have the one right next to it, which is called the bass clarinet, and the one right next to it, which is called the alto clarinet. They're all different size. The soprano one is the smallest one, then the alto is the next one bigger, and then the bass is the biggest one that they have. Now these are called woodwinds, so usually they are made out of wood and they have a piece of wood called a reed that they actually have on the top of the instrument that allows them to play the instrument. Now you can't really see it in those pictures, but you can hear it in the video here. This is a group of three soprano clarinets, one alto clarinet, and one bass clarinet. Let's listen. Thank you. is the clarinet. You can hear it sounds, the highest one, the soprano clarinet, sounds really high, and you can hear that they wiggle their fingers a lot to make some of their sound, and it goes all the way down to the bass clarinet that sounds really, really low. So those are the clarinets in the family. Now, you're almost gonna hear that video again. We can't have that. That's a lot of clarinet. All right, the next one we're gonna talk about is the oboe and the English horn, which is like a bigger version of the oboe. Now you might take a look at it and go, well, it looks just like the clarinet. It's the exact same thing, but it isn't. It's a little bit thinner. So if you actually look at it straight on, the clarinet's maybe about this thin, and then the oboe's a little bit thinner. They use the same kind of keys, as you can see from the picture, but the biggest difference is the reed. You see the reed, instead of having one piece of wood, has two pieces of wood that are stuck together, and you blow through the middle, and that makes the sound. Now the English horn, it's a little bit bigger, but you play it the same way. So really quickly, we're gonna listen to this oboe solo. I might have to skip a little bit in because it takes a little bit to get started. This one does a really good job. You can see the hands move. So that was the oboe really quick. It sounded kind of a little bit silly at first, really kind of high up there and really silly. But when you play it really beautifully like that, it sounds amazing. It takes a lot of work and a lot of practice to make that happen. Now, to keep on moving, and the last the last woodwind we're going to talk about today is the bassoon. Now, the bassoon is like the big brother to the oboe. The bassoon itself also uses a double reed, which you can actually see here at the bottom. And it's built, so it's actually really tall. It's like up to, you know, right my shoulder or something like that. And you can see them when they play that they actually have to use a special sitting strap and a special way to hold it. But they use the same kind of keys and they use a piece of wood and they're made out of wood. So these are woodwinds. Now, this one here down at the bottom, which looks like a big tube all bent up, that is called a contrabassoon, which is an even bigger bassoon, so it plays even lower. Now, really quick, we're gonna listen to a little bit of the bassoon section. The start of this video is a lot of talking, so I'm just gonna skip to the middle.
I think the fun thing about this kind of...
Front. Hold on. Here we go. That's a contrabassoon. So it's a really quick snippet that I had to give you because we have to keep on moving on, but that is the bassoon and the contrabassoon. It really does sound like an oboe grew up and it plays a lot lower, but the cool thing is the bassoon actually can play really, really low and really, really high too if it really wanted to. So, on moving. Now we get into the brass instruments. Remember, those are the ones that are made out of metal called brass. A lot of these, like this one right here, which is the trumpet, use valves that you press up and down to change the sound. And they blow into this part here at the front called a mouthpiece. So the trumpet is one of the smallest brass instruments, which means it usually plays some of the highest sound. So right now we're gonna listen to this guy play a little bit of trumpet.
Mm-hmm.
was the trumpet. You could hear it can go a little bit low, but it also goes really high. And when you get really good at it, you can mess with those valves a little bit and even mess with your lips a little bit to make it sound even funnier. Trumpet's a lot of fun. Skip ahead. All right, now the next brass instrument we're going to talk about is the French horn. Now the French horn is what happens is when you take a trumpet, you stretch it out a bit and you twist it around a bit more. Now you can't really tell, maybe you can, but the French horn is actually played backwards. You still blow through the mouthpiece here at the front and you have all the valves that change the sound, but this part here, the bell where the sound comes out, actually faces backwards. Now, I honestly don't know why they do this. They just decided that's how they want to make it, but it makes it so that, well, the sound comes out the back, but it still sounds like a really cool instrument, as you can hear here. Here it could get really soft, it can also get really loud and plays really high, and then got down really low at the end. The French horn can do a lot of things. It's actually a really neat instrument to play. Move on. Now this next one is my personal favorite because it's the one that I play, and that's the trombone. Now the trombone is different from other instruments. Usually with other brass instruments you have those three valves that you press down like this for the trumpet or like this for the French horn. But with the trombone, it's different. They make all their sounds with a slide that moves in and out. When the slide comes in closer, the note is higher. When it goes out further, the note is lower. Now, sometimes, yes, they do have a little extra trigger that adds a little extra valve and pipe to it, but that doesn't happen all the time. So let's listen really quick to the trombone. Now, because the trombone is bigger, it makes usually a lower sound. So let's take a listen. So that's the trombone very briefly. And yep, it can sound really high, but it's also just as good sounding really, really low. And you can see the slides moving in and out all the time to change the notes. Now to move on, we're gonna move on to percussion. Now these ones, unfortunately, those links don't work, so we don't have videos, so we just gotta kind of move around and talk to them. Now, percussion comes in two forms. The first one is what we call mallet percussion. And as you can see from these pictures, they use special sticks called mallets to play the instrument. And playing the instrument is kind of like playing the piano. They have things called keys that when you hit them with the mallet, the sound goes down the key and usually goes into these pipes to make the sound. Now a xylophone usually has wood or plastic keys. A marimba also usually has wood or plastic keys and is a lot bigger. And the vibraphone usually has metal keys and a special little thing on the bottom that spins around to make it sound kind of wobbly or like it's vibrating. So those are the mallet percussion instruments. Now the next up are the drum percussion instruments. Now there are a bunch of these, but these are ones that don't have notes like the mallet percussion. They just make sound, but you still use a drumstick or a special mallet to make the sound. For example, you have the snare drum over here on the left, which I'm sure you've heard all the time in like rock bands, it's part of their drum set. This one in the middle is an African drum called a djembe, and you actually play that with your hands. You don't use a stick at all. Up here on the top right are the bongos, which come in two different sizes, so they have a higher sound and a lower sound. And that one you also play with your hands. The ones on the bottom here are called timpani or kettle drums, because they're usually look like a big pot or a kettle. Now these ones you do use mallets on, but you can't really see it in the picture. They actually have things that you can mess with your feet to actually change their sound a little bit. So sometimes they can sound low and sometimes they can sound high. They're kind of in between drums and mallet percussion when it comes to sound. Now moving on, we have all the strings in the orchestra. Now, starting off on the smallest, we have the violin. After that, we have the viola, which is a little bit bigger. After that, you have the cello, which is bigger than that. You'll have to sit down. And then after that, you have the string bass or the upright bass, which is the biggest one. You actually have to stand up to play it. Now, all those instruments, like the one we'll see in the video here of the two cellos guys, they play by moving their fingers up and down the fingerboard and using what's called a bow to move across the strings to get it to vibrate and get it to cause the sound. But that's not how all string instruments work. There's one of them called the guitar, which I'm sure you all know. You still use your hands on the fingerboard, but you usually strum the strings to get them playing. Now, we're gonna really quickly listen to the two cellos guys play a little bit of cello. And they're on a bow. With that, but did you see how they were able to move their hands up and down the fingerboard? When their hands got a little closer to where they were moving the bow, the note went higher. When it went further up, closer to where their head is, the note went lower. Now, you might have also seen all the strings on their bows kind of flying all over the place. Well, that's because that string is actually made out of horsehair. So they give the horses a little bit of a haircut and they keep that hair, they wash it and they clean it all up and they put it onto the bows, and that's what makes it have its sound. Now, we're going to go on to that again. If we take all of those instruments and we mix them together, we get the orchestra. If we look at the picture below, we see that we have the violins, the violas, and the cellos at the front. Behind the cellos are the double basses or the upright basses. Behind the violins and the violas are the flutes and the oboes, so our woodwinds. Then we have the clarinets and the bassoons kind of behind that, more woodwinds. And then behind all that, we'll have the French horns, the trumpets, the trombones, and the tubas, who we didn't talk about. But those are all the brass instruments. And then there's the contrabasses, which are even lower. Then usually in the back, you'll have maybe a harp or a piano, a cornet, which is a special type of brass instrument. A piccolo is a special type of woodwind instrument. Those are usually with them sometimes. And then all the percussion instruments, the timpani, the gong, the xylophone, the vibraphone, the snare drum, the organ, all those other instruments combined together to make the orchestra, which when it combines together, sounds a little something like this. Again, wish we had more time to watch that video all the way through, but it's really long and we've actually had a lot of time with this lesson today. I took a lot of time telling you all about these instruments. Now, I hope you had fun learning about these instruments, because the next time we meet each other, we're actually going to follow along on a story that uses these instruments to tell a story. But we'll get to that next time. Until then, I hope you have a good time in class and I'll see you then.